Ladies and gentlemen, Bentall Taylor Ulrich.
It was not a big stretch that we were available, really.
You so beat me to that one. I'm just so happy to have a gig.
And do you like our windscreens? They're actually functioning as windscreens, but it was so handy. I mean, before this, who walked around with masks? Now we have them for so many purposes.
Well, thank you, Holger, and your family for hosting this. I think that's just wonderfully generous and supportive of you. It's very nice of you, and how lovely to be playing music in front of people. It's been for entertainers and musicians. It's been a strange time for everybody, but also for us, you know, I mean, in some ways, I think we'll be some of the last people that will go back to work. So it's lovely to get a chance here and there to do this. So thank you.
We will remember this day for the rest of our lives, for the first time we got to play for humans. Thank you for coming. If it was just the cows, it wouldn't be quite as good.
You're the one that's needing change.
Thank you. Thank you.
I've been doing the odd solo live stream in the corner of my little basement studio. And it was pretty exciting at first on Zoom to see little squares of humans, but it's just nothing like the real thing. Very, very grateful to be here. Everybody okay? Can I get you anything? A beverage? Some snacks? This is a the album called Back to Shore, and it's a song that was kind of brewing for many years as the lines on my face, the roadmap to life, kept growing. I kept thinking, there must be a good use for these.
As old as Well, this is a song from a solo record that I made a number of years ago that Barney produced. And I was trying to, it's a songwriting exercise. I watched a show in the Civil War, and I was fascinated kind of by the fife and the drum and how the soldiers would follow these two guys into battle. And so I thought I'd write a verse, one with the fife and one with the drum, and it kind of wound its way through songwriting world and ended up kind of being about sort of the moral dilemma that that a conscripted soldier might go through, which is pretty uplifting stuff. These uplifting times.
Well, I just learned a very interesting thing about the start of the Civil War, that the first big battle, all the socialites gathered on the hillside above the first battle, having picnics, basically, thinking it would be over, and that one first battle. It's remarkable to think. So, sorry, I just thought I'd bring it uplift
image.
It a bit more.
Yeah.
But
the drum. Should the Lord turn me away? somewhere in between.
Thank you.
You knew the words. I love that.
Aww. Thank you.
Why, you must have purchased an album at a concert, just like we have available here tonight. How unusual.
My dad was a Baptist minister. Let's get that out of the way right now. anyways, this is a song off my latest record called The Drifter and the Preacher, and this song is called The Preacher. Preacher shakes the hands of all the members of the congregation as they are birthed out into the blinding light across from the railway station, figuring they might have cheated the devil out of one more week. Blessed are the meek. They sit down to Sunday dinner where the preacher's wife has laid a table. Tension across the linen cloth, a taut and rusty cable. The eldest daughter steps outside into the alley to get high. Blessed are the hungry, for they'll be satisfied. Oh, hallelujah. Hey. Sets out upon the ocean, seagulls circling overhead in a slow swirling motion.
holding a woman's hand, still staring down the barrel of a shaky start. Blessed are the pure of heart. Decades later on his deathbed, the preacher wonders why it mattered. You live your life under the load of some code that leaves your family scattered. They both want to talk, but the best they can do is a handshake and a nod. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they are the children of God. Oh,
thank you very much. This is an element having not played for a long time. Well, the most important part of that equation, it just feels very good to do. But also words, you're thinking, oh, don't start thinking about what's coming next. You'll be completely lost. You're sort of hoping the words will come.
How did it turn out for
you? So far, so good.
Okay, good. Any questions so far? Anybody okay? Well, sorry, was that a question? I have no control over what you do.
Absolutely.
Feel free.
Of course.
Wait. Okay. Certainly. Okay, I'm going to be looking at you.
To answer your question directly, I'm completely comfortable with it. This age, anybody wants to take my picture and go, hey, that's not so bad.
Bye.
how prophetic the last verse of that song was going to become.
Yeah.
Yeah, whoa. It's also really liberating to have room to play, because I've been in the tiny little corner of my studio where I can swivel on the piano bench to the guitar, and everything has to be within arm's length. I cannot move from this spot. So I'm feeling free as a bird. Woo! I can tell you're really excited about that. I'm very excited about that. Perhaps a little too excited.
I think it's you.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
It's me. Jeez.
That's why we make set lists, Tom. That's why we labor over them for minutes and minutes. Tuning's a little weird.
It's a little bit short.
Not complaining.
All right, well, this is a song called The Wind Don't Lie, and my wife and I both, over the years since we were very young. My wife was born on Salt Spring Island, and my family has had a place over there for 52 years or something. So we spent a lot of time probably in the same places when we were kids, and we always wondered whether we'd seen each other. And we wondered whether there's old pictures that both of us might be in the archives or something. So anyway, I thought about that when I wrote this song.
Trees.
Thank you so much.
This is a new one that I wrote. We have, the three of us are also in this bluegrass band called the High Bar Gang. And we've done two records, all of traditional songs. One was more of a gospel record, and the other is a cheating and hurting record. And so we're working towards doing one of original songs. So it's actually kind of freeing to write just in sort of that a different perspective instead of the usual navel-gazing thing that it is when you're on singer-songwriter.
It is easier to have guidelines or a framework of some sort rather than what I refer to as the abyss of infinite possibility.
Yeah. One of my sisters started a remarkable thing in the downtown east side. It just said its 15th anniversary, and it's she and some other people started the Listening Post, and it's just a storefront, right, sort of ground zero down there, and it's a comfortable place to sit and be, and it's always sort of there's somebody there that knows how to listen, and people just come in and talk, and it's used all the time, and just have a chance to tell their stories. And I was thinking about that when I wrote this song. It's called Home.
Yeah, you make a deal with the devil.
you very much.
Sorry about my bad note.
Okay, you got two more tries.
Well, some of you may have heard this story, but I can't change it because it's the truth, so I'll just have to tell it to you again, and you can, well, if you're anything like me, you don't remember stories anyway. All of our friends and I were all going through at least the third or fourth round, and each time it's, oh yeah, now I don't remember that story. It's great. I get to tell the same ones over and over. So when I was 18 years old, I was on a college campus in Santa Fe, California, and very involved in the peace movement. And Kent State happened, and suddenly I did not feel safe being in my hometown or my home country. And I happened to still be living at home, but my mother was off in Europe, so the car was there, and I figured, well, I'll just load it up and go to Canada. And I was not all that well educated, apparently, because I truly did think that Canada was just wilderness, and anybody who wanted to settle here would homestead. So I was prepared to do that. I had my book on how to build a log cabin in the woods. That was the title. And how to build.
Did you have a chainsaw too, or did?
No, I didn't. Okay. No, I didn't think that far ahead. I was young, and I rolled into Vancouver. Thought, okay, this is not quite what I expected, but it did feel different. It has always felt different, and has always felt kinder and gentler. And as we have all said at one point or another in the last few months, we are so grateful to be living in Canada. So this is my tribute to my adopted country, to all of our adopted country. All wrong.
I was looking for a life and a little more, and I found you.
particularly when you're looking
at... Yeah, you know what? I harmonized in whistle, and then I was so impressed that then everything fell apart after that, but I was like...
It was fantastic.
This song's off the last record that the three of us did together called Tightrope Walk, and it's a song called Chased by the Devil, which kind of started out as a practice exercise that my kids would listen to me play and ask me if it was a song, and told me I should turn it into a song. So it's a practice exercise. It's a song, so hopefully we don't get through this and you don't think that I should practice more.
And we're very obedient. We always do what our kids tell us to do.
That was going to be our last song, and then we'd go somewhere, like, hiding behind these beautiful trees for an encore. I don't know. Go commune with the cows for a while. I don't know. Oh, really? Oh, my God.
Oh, I'm so surprised. Oh.
Would you like to hear a few more songs? This is like the old days of show business, three shows in one day. At a dairy farm. If you keep doing this job long enough, there's always new stuff coming around the corner. What are we going to do?
I think we should do those three, but in a different order.
Okay. No, if we only do two, then there's going to be, you know, a horrible band fight afterwards.
Yeah, like usually happens. Yeah, that's true.
Oh, there's disappearing too, right?
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Well, by the time we finish discussing it, there's one song time, yeah.
Oh, yeah. So where are we going to start with? Hey, we're out of practice. You know, like, what can we...
Let's do...
And in the key of D?
I think we're doing it in D, yeah. Okay. This is a song that is the reason that I have a career in Canada. It was written by Joe Mock of the Pied Pumpkin and made more famous by the hometown band. And we're going to sing it for you right now. I have declared. Coming off? Should I be worried? Something.
Help me out of this space. Oh,
consensus. Everything's good. Cows are so quiet. Are they sleeping? They're chewing.
Imagine, Holger, if your milk production went way up.
We'd have to come out every week.
It was music. That's what does it. Well, if you're gonna do, I'm gonna do a song that I wouldn't have a career without this song, and the connection to Chilliwack. Although I know we're in, how did your navigation thing pronounce Agassi? It was hilarious.
Oh, what?
Agassi.
Agassi, right?
Agassi's. So funny when I was at a point in my life, we had four young kids, and I thought, this is ridiculous. I got to quit music. And we thought, well, I got to give it one more try. And we wrote this next song. We made a video, which happened to get a lot of airplay or play on TV, and which enabled me, I got a record deal with Sony or Columbia at the time. And then they wanted to get this big English producer to produce our record. He ended up doing it, but we needed to get a gig so he could come and see us and then see whether he wanted to work with us or not. And the only place we could get a gig was Earthquake Annie's in Chilliwack. And so we went out there. I mean, this was kind of our norm, but for him, he came up from Los Angeles and got in a car and drove to Earthquake Annie's.
Well, it worked.
And the rest is just checkered history. So here we go. Yeah. Thank you.
I don't know. So we ask Andy, we need to ask Andy. Andy, you look cold. Did you bring another coat? Okay. Okay, good. Just want to make sure. We're going to do one more song once we decide what it is. Is that okay? Okay, good. I was only asking Andy. Very, very, very nice of you to come spend your afternoon here.
Sure is.
And whatever it takes to keep live music in your community is a wonderful thing. And Andy, you are a saint. Oh, he's busy talking to someone. You're both saints. Holger, Andy, so grateful to you. And to you, whose name I do not know, but clearly you're a big part of this. Oh, good.
And Kenny, thanks for the sound.
Thank you, Ken. Now you're starting to look like everyone else because you have a mask on, so I couldn't tell for sure.
Sunrise on another long day. I've been
All right, thanks so much, folks.
Thank you, Taylor. Everybody.
Jerry Ulrich and Barney Bentall.
Thank you.
You.
Thanks, everybody. Stay safe out there. And thanks for the courage of coming. Appreciate it.